بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، ما بعد. In his Risala, his treatise on dhikr, Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala, an alim rabbani, a faqih, known for his fiqh, known for his jurisprudence, known for his Islamic, his knowledge, his wisdom, and his benefit to the Muslim community. He compiled a treatise of adhkar, of a treatise that has the remembrance of Allah, the Almighty, in it, different ways to remember Allah, from a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And one of the ahadith that he mentioned in the beginning, when he talked about the benefits of dhikr, of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned the hadith of Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أسعد الناس بشفاعة يوم القيامة من قال لا إله إلا الله خالصا من قلبه أو نفسه. رواه البخاري. He mentioned the hadith that was narrated by Imam Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala, the great Imam, Amir al-Hadith, Amir al-Mu'mineen fi Hadith. And Imam Bukhari mentioned this hadith of the Prophet that was narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, the people most deserving of my shafa'ah, of my intercession on the day of judgment, are those who say La ilaha illallah, there is no God worthy except Allah, worthy of worship except Allah, khalisan min qalbihi, with sincerity in his heart or from himself. And this is was narrated in Bukhari. In this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it shows us again the importance and the benefit of dhikr, and that the one who says La ilaha illallah, that says that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, with sincerity in his heart, again, that shows us that shart, one of those conditions for having our deeds accepted, which is ikhlas lillah. And the second one is mutabi', that we follow the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so the one who says in his heart, who says with sincerity, La ilaha illallah, that this person is of those who is deserving, the most deserving of the shafa'a of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of judgment, on Yawm al-Qiyamah. And this is something azeem, and something that we all want, this shafa'a. And Ahl Islam are those people who will receive the various types of shafa'a of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from those people, from the some of the people who were some of the major sinners, but they were still Muslim, and they entered the hellfire. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will make shafa'ah for them to be taken out of the hellfire and entered into Jannah after some punishment. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will make shafa'ah or intercession for those also who are in Jannah to be raised to another higher level of Jannah, that they will be raised in status, in darajat, in Jannah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And these are just some of the types of shafa'a that are mentioned in the authentic ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the shahid, or the main point, and the reason Ibn Uthaymeen, he mentioned this, he mentioned this to talk about the fadl of dhikr. Dhikr Allah Ta'ala mutlaqan, meaning that the benefit of remembering Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, and that it's unrestricted. Of course, it's restrained by the Sharia. Of course, we don't want to get the idea like those people who are extremists, who go beyond the bounds of the Sharia, that they make new kinds of dhikr in ways that they have no right to do so by doing various types of bid'ah and innovation. Because the Prophet ﷺ let us know that we must follow his sunnah, and that we cannot, and that whoever, من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه هو رد, whoever innovates in this affair of ours will have it rejected. So the Prophet ﷺ let us know that dhikr is restricted by his sunnah. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil, and bless us to be of those who make dhikr often. And may Allah accept our good deeds and forgive our evil ones. وَصَلَى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلَّمَ.